Good afternoon. My name is Divya Porwal and I am currently pursuing BSc Forensic Science from Medicaps University, Indore. I heartily thankful for having this opportunity. Thank you, ma'am. My topic is role of biological evidence in crime scene investigation. Initially, see about what is biological evidence, or biological evidence is a type of evidence which mostly found at crime scene, and they are like body fluids, tissues, organs, etc. Biological evidence are the most common type of evidence found at the crime scene. It is a physical evidence classified founded on the essence of the evidence. The word biological derived from the word biology, referring to living organism, whereas indication is defined as something honestly accepted to a skilled court as a means of verifying the truth of any likely course of fact under investigation before it, or information that is used in court of law, demonstrate something. The identification of several biological specimens at a scene can be a crucial because biological evidence contain DNA, and it is a very crucial evidence found at the crime scene, and it is a very important evidence in the investigation of any case. The existence of a distinct liquid may be important in the end of itself. Also, biological materials can be on basis of DNA, which can enable an individual to be correlated to a scene and a particular biological species. DNA can be attained from a mixture of reference, including blood, skin cells, semen, hair, saliva, tissue, and etc. The type of items that the DNA sample is placed on may also be a significant. So biological evidence are present at crime scene in the form of like saliva, urine, tissue, semen, blood, etc. All are the most common type of evidence which are found at the crime scene. And it is clearly see that biological evidence means it is derived from the word biology. And in biology, we learn about many type of things like related to body, bodily fluids, etc. Then we see about identification of evidence at crime scene. So identification of biological evidence at crime scene are involved in mainly two type of identification or examinations. Our first physical examination, then second is alternative light source. In physical examination, we see evidence in physical or by our naked eyes or without any instruments in physical examination, and it is also known as visual inspection. It means inspection of the evidence or identification of evidence in the visual eyes, and it has to identify a range of time of biological fluids out from the body by its color and texture. Like in blood, if the color is dark or the color range is approximately at brown, or the texture is dry, so confirms that the evidence is older evidence or it have some time to release from the human body or any of the living body. Then the second one is alternative light source. In this method, UV light used as alternative light source means any light on UV light, which is used as alternative light source that reveals the following type of fluids at crime scene. In crime scene or that are within crime scene, as a seminal fluid, urine means if any type of if semen evidence is present at the crime scene. So by the alternative light source, we see that the sample is originally a semen or the something else it is present. So if the semen is present, then it shows a particular light by the UV light, so it shows that the evidence is true, not false. Types of cases involved in biological evidence at crime scene. Most common is murder or sexual assault. In murder, there are evidences like blood, saliva, tissues, etc. Blood is the most common in murder cases, which is which death was happened by any tool or injury. But if it is not, if the blood is not present, so we can say that the death was happened, but if blood is not present in these type of cases like hanging or drawing, so in these type of cases, we consider saliva as a biological evidence if blood is not present, because both the evidence or biological, mainly biological evidence are collected are having the DNA. DNA is the most important part which we extract from the biological evidence, which is used to solve the crime. Then we consider about tissues. So tissues are in the activity of self-defense or any fight. So skin tissue are collected in the nails of the person and we will collect it. Then in sexual assault, the most common evidence is semen. Without semen, we cannot consider that the case was of sexual assault case. Then collection and preservation. So collection and preservation are the most useful part of chain of custody. And the techniques are same for all the, mainly all the type of biological evidences, because the composition of biological evidences are approximately same. So means it is present in liquid or dried form. Then the liquid or wet one is collected by the cotton tip applicator, or if the chances is high to get contaminate, the evidence will dried, the evidence in natural or at the room temperature in the presence of an expert, and then collect it by the plucker or collect it as it is if it is present in on a small surface. If it is on large surface, then cut out the surface, then collect it. If the evidence already present in right form, then put it as with the help of plucker and cover it in a evidence collection bag, which is in brown color. For the preservation of biological evidence, put the evidence in low temperature or refrigerate at 2 degree to 8 degree Celsius, or isolate it in secure area that a suspect or any other person cannot touch it or able to destroy it. Then we come to the about safety and precautions. So safety and precautions. So safety and precautions are the useful for biological evidence are mostly, and for all type of evidence, it is important, because to avoid contamination, we have to use safety and precautions. Otherwise, the evidence was contaminated and it has no use in solving the crime. So the first and most common type of safety and precautions used by any investigator is wearing gloves and wearing masks. It is the most important. Then some type of things which any human being apply, like cosmetic products. These are the things which have contaminated the evidence, and there is more chances to contaminate the evidence. And avoid cosmetics or any type of deodorants, lotions or oils used by a human, and identify biohazardous evidence material. Package in container. Biohazardous or biological hazard means biological substance that poses a threat to the health of living organism, primarily in humans, mainly in humans. This could include a sample or of a microorganism, virus, toxin, bacteria, etc. A biohazard could also be substance harmful to the animals also. Conclusion of this poster is biological evidence contain bodily fluids and tissues which have a significance of DNA analysis. DNA consists in blood, saliva, semen, urine, fecal material, vaginal secretions, etc. Collect the evidence carefully by applicators and avoid the contamination. Thank you so much, ma'am.